Hello everyone, this is Eric Kolscher, and today I'm giving the second screencast in my screencast series about debugging Django, and today it is on logging. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's get the test server up and running, make sure everything's working. And it is, and today we're going to be debugging a little different project. It's a script I wrote to get lyrics from the internet, so let's go ahead and do some Tool Sober Lyrics, great song. It's working good, so let's go ahead and let's see what people are doing on the site. This is in obviously in the debug server, so let's just make sure the queries are getting through. I've already debugged this one, so it works. But let's just go down and go ahead and print out. Query was just really simple, see what the query is. This is a good way just to see kind of what's going on with your server, and since we're running the test server, all print statements get printed out to standard output. So here we go. The query was Tool Sober Lyrics, so it looks like everything's working fine. So let's go ahead and do a little something more, a little harder. Let's say we're trying to get this during production. So we're going to use the logging module. So let's go ahead and do logging.error, just so the error call does it to standard out, so we'll also be able to see it in the terminal. And let's just refresh that page. And up here we should see, yep, error root, that means it's from the root window, and query. So that's working well, so the logging module is working fine. And that's very contrived, so let's go ahead and use a real example of some code that I've written. So I'm going to go ahead and go, you might have heard of test maker. It basically just takes views that are processed on the test server and outputs them to the to a log file. So let's go ahead and just look how that's implemented and show you a couple more features of the Django logging module. So as you see here, we import logging, and then log is git logger test maker, so that's just getting a specialized logger. So if ever I wanted to put in a settings file test maker, that I could have special settings just for this special logger. You can have different instances of it. It's one of the cool things you can do with the Python logger. So let's go ahead and see what it's just logging the posts and stuff. What you're doing in the format of a unit test. So let's go ahead and look at the management command where it gets invoked, and that's going to show us kind of how to do basic setup. Here you go. Here's the logging.basicinfo. The level is logging level info, and that means everything from info and worse will get captured. So info, warn, and error. The format, you can do really cool stuff with timestamps and other things like that. At the moment, it's just a very simple message that I'm printing out, but if you're doing real kind of like logging of requests and things like that, you might want a timestamp. There's lots of other cool stuff. File name, log file is actually declared higher up in the file. It's just a string of where you want to put the log file. And then file mode. And that's all there really is to it. So let's go ahead and just see that in action. And to do that, we're going to actually have to cancel run server. And there's a management command, as I was saying. It takes the exact same arguments as run server, except it inserts that middleware in and sets up the logging and all that good stuff. So when we go ahead and make some requests, and it takes a little while because it's searching Google, but let's just do Radiohead. Let's do Kid A. Sounds good to me. And then we can go. We can actually tail the log file, and as we enter stuff, you'll see it's the problem with it getting lyrics automatically is that sometimes you get stuff from song meanings. But anyway, dispatch the general, as we can see, this file is getting all this stuff appended to it as we're going, and that's the beauty of logging, is that You can have stuff output to the terminal, you can have it output to a file, you can do it across a network. You can do some really neat things with it. And just by wrapping all your print statements and stuff in the logging module, it gives you the ability to go back later and kind of do with it what you want without having to change any of your code. So even if you're just printing stuff out to terminal or doing some really simple stuff, you never know what you might want to do in the future. And this stuff can run in production because it's just printing to a file. So it's always a good idea to kind of wrap it up in the logging module. I forgot this was a tail. So that's always good to know, is just the power of the logging module with just one very basic configuration file. Now I'm going to go ahead and show you another cool thing that you can do. It's actually the, as you see there, that's erroring out. Next screencast, I'm going to show you how to debug that error. But I'm going to go ahead and show you the settings.debug file, which is the standard place where we put the stuff for debugging. And I'm going to go ahead and show off the Django middleware, or the Django logging middleware. You can find it here. I'll go ahead and show you. If you haven't yet, please go install it. It's Django logging. Just search Google. It should be the first result, or the Django logging Google project. It's really nice. It has a couple nice features that I'm going to show you. And this is just one of those really cool things that you get for free. Once you wrap all your stuff in logging, then you can do these other really neat things where it's already in the logging module, so you can just redirect it as you want. So let's go ahead and save that. The internal IPs, it only works on internal IPs, just like the first screencast. Whatismyip.com, a great place to grab that internal IP. So let's go back and just do run server again. And you should see at the bottom of this page, it's actually going to output my log message. As you can see here, the request log error, the query was dispatched to the general. That's really, really cool. And this is for whatever you choose to be logging. This is kind of a contrived result, but if you're logging anything important, it's really cool to be able to see it on each page. It's a really good debugging tool that you can use interactively. Let's do some free-falling lyrics. Yeah, as we can see, there's not anything too much to it. But now, I actually, this hasn't been released yet, but I've actually built the Django logging middleware into TestMaker, so it'll make use of that. So if we go ahead and run TestMaker, then this hasn't been released, so if people want it, I'm going to release it in the next couple of days. So if we run TestMaker, we'll get some cool output. As we can see, it's doing the self assert equals. Down here is some really cool stuff. You can see that the cache is true, which means this is being returned out of the cache instead of finding it. The search, and then the content. It's really cool. And I just kind of found this when I was trying to do this screencast, that you could do this, and that's really handy. And so whatever you choose to log or debug on every view, it's just a nice way, instead of using the error page, you can kind of get some of the data from the error page out to the bottom of the page without having it error, just by logging. And then if you want to do logging while in production, you can do that as well, and you just take that out, and it'll log to a log file, or hell, you could get it to send you an IM. You can do some really neat stuff with it, because you can do whatever you want. You can redirect it as you want. There's one more really cool feature that I'm going to show you with Django logging, and we're going to have to go to settings debug, and that is the logging SQL. If you change logging SQL equals true, this is on by default, you get some really cool stuff as well. So when we go ahead and refresh the page, it's now going to show us all of our SQL queries as well. And this is a great debugging tool, because when you see the amount of SQL queries on a page, it gives you a really good idea of what's slowing it down, if there's a ton. You can make some very small changes in Django and get really good performance benefits out of it. So here you can see it's getting all the sites. It's a very simple SQL queries. There's only about 6 of them. Somewhere up here it should be getting it, yeah. Here's where it's looking for it in the cache, and it's all the TestMaker stuff. And it's just so handy to have all this stuff in your browser when you're trying to use it. So that's about as much as I have on logging. I'm sure there's lots of really cool Python logging things. And just go ahead and play around with it, and just try to wrap all your stuff in the logging module, and it gives you some really, really cool stuff. All right, thank you. Have a good day.